My name is Michelle, and I got a speeding ticket. I'm at traffic court, and I'm here to fight back.
We have a winner. 61 on this car coming at us.
We first met Michelle speeding on State Road 838. It was 9:57 a.m., and she was rushing to get to work by 10.
Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi. The reason I pulled you over is you're doing 61 and a 45.
Speeding. Yeah, I know. I'm just on my
way
to work.
We're late for work.
We're late. I'm in a hurry to get to work.
All right, ma'am. I'm going to be issuing you a speeding ticket. You were doing 16 over the limit.
I got a ticket.
But it's
all good because I'm going to fight it.
Three months later, Michelle is on time to court. And she's brought her defense team with her.
Hi, Michelle, you brought a couple people with you. Who are you all?
I did. This is my fiance, Thomas, or Tommy. And this is the witness that was in the car with me the day we stopped, Lisa.
Lisa, okay. And are you prepared for trial, Michelle?
I am.
Okay, officer, tell me what led you to write this young lady a citation.
Yes, ma'am. I was clocking westbound traffic when I observed a 2008 Suzuki, and it indicated a speed of 61 in a posted 45, which is 16 over the limit.
And Michelle, do you have any questions for the officer? Anything you want to ask him?
Well, yeah. Were there any other cars on the road around me the time that you actually pointed your little radar thing at me?
It was a laser, and yes, there was.
Laser.
Yes, there was.
Were there any other questions you had for the officer?
Not for the officer.
All right, you
I want don't.
To tell me what happened?
Yes, I do.
Great.
I was going through a lot of problems when I was driving. My history is not very good. I have a lot of felonies and misdemeanors on my record. Lisa and I were on our way to work that morning, traveling the same route I always take. I have some back problems going on, and I want to refer you to the letter from my doctor. I had an eviction notice right around that time, too, a couple days before that. I'm looking at being thrown out of my apartment and because I've missed work being in the hospital, you know? Don't go to work, don't make money, don't pay the bills, right? Y'all know what I mean, you know? Heaven forbid you get sick a couple days or have to go in the hospital.
Michelle, I need you to talk to me.
I'm sorry.
You got to persuade.
I'm sorry. I'm just talking, yeah.
That's okay.
You know, they know, too. I got a job, first time in my life, okay? I've done really well in my job. I got top seller.
But tell me more about the speeding, because that's what I have jurisdiction
over. Okay. I was very, very stressed out over the eviction and where money's going to come from. And my birthday was just Monday. You know, it's a miracle I lived 40 years. But still, you know, with financial problems going on, it was a little depressing coming up on my birthday. And with all the stress, it was really hurting my back, too, on the way there.
Okay.
So I was in pain.
Okay, so how fast do you think you were going?
I don't think I was going 61.
Okay.
I don't.
Okay, so then, Lisa, is there something you wanted to add?
Well, I'd just like to say that we were discussing her eviction notice and being in a lot of pain and going through different doctors and stuff.
Okay. And Officer Ricagliano, is there anything you want to add?
There was no problems, Your Honor. I will say that in all the years I've been doing this, you probably was the nicest person I've ever pulled over. I would ask that whatever you can do for this young lady would probably be the most appropriate thing. I think she definitely learned her lesson.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
so,
you.
So, having heard the evidence on behalf of the state and on behalf of the defense, what you've told me about not feeling that you were going that fast isn't a legal defense to a speeding ticket, but given all the information you have told me about your background and the officer's recommendation, that's certainly a mitigating factor. And on that basis, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at your driving record. And your driving record shows that you haven't had any speedings on your record for over 10 years.
Yeah.
Your driving history is not this.
Yeah.
So on that basis, it'll be $150 in court costs. You have no school and no points.
Thank goodness.
Right.
Thank you,
have 60
you
days
very
to
much.
Pay.
Woo-hoo!
Hi.
Yay!
I told you.
We got it. Court costs only $150. No $200 10 ticket, no traffic school, no points. Woohoo!
Michelle was cruising above the speed limit, so she was found guilty. But she deserves a break, so I withheld the points in school.
It pays to fight back.
It sure does.
Stand up for what you believe in.
Yeah.